Father, what a wonderful privilege to come and draw near to you again this morning. We thank you, Lord, that we know that whenever we draw near to you, you draw near to us as well. We thank you, we worship you, we ask, O God, that you will bless this word and that this word, according to your Bible, will not return void. We thank you and we worship you in Jesus' name. Amen. Why is it that people love to see their name in lights? Almost like the old Broadway stars. People are so obsessed with themselves sometimes. And that is many times one of the most biggest problems and obstacles in ministry. A minister once called it the unholy trinity: me, myself, and I. Teresa Saputis once said that she had the opportunity to work with most of the so-called great ministers, and she has found them all to have feet of clay. I've personally heard evangelists shouting out all those little rhymes. I remember the one shouting from the pulpit, "I am the man that can. I've got the power for the hour." I want to start this off today. And I want to tell you, there's only one name that should be in stars, in lights. Only one name that should be exclaimed. Let me read to you and quote the author. John 14 verse 6. Jesus saith unto him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh to the man cometh unto the Father but by me." So the name in lights should be his and his only. We are but road markers or signposts pointing to him. And this brings me to the topic of my message this morning. I sincerely believe that we were not called only to build massive structures and ministries in our name, but rather to win the lost at any cost. We must be fishermen and women, the salt and the light, the road markers to the one who saves, Jesus Christ. There are many evangelistic tools, and it is important that you should study the word and find what works best for you. We had EE3, The Way of the Master, many, many more. In the middle 80s, I found an easy method I personally liked because it used only the Word of God. I remember sitting with all my Bibles and marking these scriptures. I went through so many Bibles through the years. Some of my small police pocket Bibles ended up being carried in plastic bags as it came apart from all the reading and marking. But back to the evangelization method, it uses the book of Romans and is therefore called the Roman Road. Now you basically have to know the first verse of the scripture reference, and that is that. And I've marked next to each verse the one that follows on that, and with an arrow pointing whether it is a further reading or whether we need to go back. Now the first one can be found at Romans 3 verse 10. As it is written, "There is none righteous, no, not one." The next one, Romans 3:23, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." Romans 5:12, "Wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned." Then a back arrow at that scripture to Romans 5 verse 8. "But God commendeth his love towards us in that, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us." Forward again, Romans 6:23. "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." Romans 10:13. "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." Back again to Romans 10:9. "That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved." Romans 10:10. "For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation." I used to end this with an invitation using Revelation 3 verse 20. "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him and he with me. Some people make a card with the scriptures on it. We also love using scripts. Whatever way you find to work with and work for you, it is okay as long as it is based on and don't deviate from the Bible. As an end note, you can also download soul winning tools from so many websites. One of them that we regularly use is found at www.revival.com/soul-winning-tools. One of the most important factors ever is that your actions must back up your words. You see, there's a saying in the world that you may be able to talk the talk, but can you walk the walk? Can you walk out that and live out that words of that you profess every day? In life, can very easily destroy your whole testimony. Thank God that mercy triumphs over judgment. Accepting Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your life, that moment that you pray the prayer, that is only the very beginning, the start of your rebirth. It is like a baby being born, but after that, that baby must grow. And the only way that a child of God can grow successfully is in and through the Word of God. Becoming not like a minister, not like a famous preacher, not like anyone else, but following the example of Jesus Christ to become like Him. I've seen churches over the years where the walls were lined with crutches, walking aids, and even wheelchairs of people that were healed in that church. Yet when you listen and look at the ministers, you find that they were doing a lot of stuff that's not in line with the Word of God. And I've often wondered why, and then one day John and Paula Sanford preached on this same topic, and the Lord answered them this very question. And God says, "You forget. I validate my word, not the preacher." But we have the wonderful privilege that according to the book of Acts, if we would live holy lives, God will confirm our preaching with signs and wonders. I want to ask you this morning, let God be God. Give Him all the glory. Obey Him. Win the lost. Point them to Jesus Christ, the Savior, our Messiah. Let us pray. Father, in this time where we are singing the song Africa Back to God, yes, the whole world back to God, we want to thank you, Lord, that you have not left us as orphans, but you have sent the Holy Spirit to protect us, to guide us every step of the way, to give us wisdom and discernment. Father, help us to walk in that. That is my prayer today. Father, as we come before you now, I bless each and every one watching this short video. I bless them with your love, your wisdom, your discernment, your mercy, and may they experience the wonderful companionship of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, thank you for being our guide. Thank you that you guided us to Jesus Christ, to salvation. And thank you, Jesus, that you not only sent us the Holy Spirit, but you introduced us to God, not only God the Creator, but God our Abba. Our Father, I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Be blessed. God loves you.
We are Emmy bele Afrika iphela ukususela eCape ukuya kusho eCairo nangu umyalezo emasufumane kwincwadi kaTimothy isahluko sesibini iverse yesithathu ukuya kweyesine onga yena bangasindiswa bonke abantu bafikelele ekuyazini inyaniso mnye kuphela umlamleli phakathi kwaThixo nabantu umntu uKristu Yesu la ngamazwi ayinhliziyo kaThixo ngawo anganika impendulo kwingxaki esinazo kwilizwe lakowethu naki ezo ezichaphazela ukutshabalala kwethu yi-AIDS naki ezo ezichaphazela imeko esigqibayo yodlame kwilizwe lakowethu uxolo kunye noThixo luyafumaneka ngokwamkela uYesu ufezakale injongo kaThixo zinkokheli zezwe lakowethu bomama bethu lutsha lwakowethu nabantu bonke mnikeni ithuba uYesu ebomini benu yimpendulo yena mamkeleni yena ngoba kubufuphi ukuba abuye mamkeleni yena ngendlela yeBhayibheli mamkeleni yena ngendlela yakuqala mamkeleni uYesu.